relationship with the right referral partner could be a game changer for any B2B company. So what if you could reverse engineer these relationships at a moment's notice? Start a podcast, invite potential referral partners to be guests on your show, and grow your referral network faster than ever. Learn more at sweetfishmedia.com.
You're listening to B2B Growth, a daily podcast for B2B leaders. We've interviewed names you've probably heard before, like Gary Vaynerchuk and Simon Sinek, but you've probably never heard from the majority of our guests. That's because the bulk of our interviews aren't with professional speakers and authors. Most of our guests are in the trenches leading sales and marketing teams. They're implementing strategy. They're experimenting with tactics. They're building the fastest growing B2B companies in the world. My name is James Carberry. I'm the founder of Sweetfish Media, a podcast agency for B2B brands, and I'm also one of the co-hosts of this show. When we're not interviewing sales and marketing leaders, you'll hear stories from behind the scenes of our own business. We'll share the ups and downs of our journey as we attempt to take over the world. Just kidding. Well, maybe. Let's get into the show.
Welcome back to the B2B Growth Show. My name is Ethan Beute, and I talk customer experience here on the show. I host great conversations with really smart folks in sales, marketing, customer success, leadership and management, and a variety of other positions, because the customer experience is the single most important thing that we create and deliver every single day as individuals and teams and companies. And yet, when you think about it, it involves every single touch point, everything front of the house that a customer or future customer may experience. So how do we work across these teams, or in a more negative context here, across these silos to create a holistic experience that we can measure and constantly improve? That's what we explore in Talking Customer Experience. And so from time to time, I share an idea or a story or something else related rather than going to an interview. And that's what we've got here on this episode. I'm talking about the service profit chain. It's a really valuable and important idea produced by three gentlemen from Harvard Business School. James L. Heskett, W. Earl Sasser Jr., and Leonard A. Schlesinger wrote the book of the same name, The Service Profit Chain. Its subtitle is How Leading Companies Link Profit and Growth to Loyalty, Satisfaction, and Value. And what they've done, when I walk this out, it's going to be a little bit intuitive. And you're going to say to yourself, yeah, this just makes sense. But I think I'm going to give you some new language to think about it. And the most important thing that these researchers did was provide proven links, proven quantified connections between all the touch points that I'm going to walk through here. So what we tend to do in leadership and management is focus on revenue growth, and profitability. We focus at the end of the line. These are outcomes based on all these upstream inputs. And so what they argue in the service profit chain is that it all starts with internal service quality. When we start and put more energy and emphasis on internal service quality, the outcomes of revenue growth and profitability are going to happen as a consequence, as opposed to looking at the outcomes and really pushing and pressing and spending a lot of time and energy trying to figure those pieces out. If we spent more of that time, it is important to focus on those things, right? It's the responsible thing to do, and you need to understand your numbers, how they're moving, and what contributes to them. But if we take some share of that time in what I call expensive meetings, when you round up some of the most well-compensated people in the organization for an hour-long or even a half-day or a full-day meeting, that's an expensive meeting. And so in these expensive meetings, if we spend more time thinking and talking about internal service quality, we're going to probably have a better effect on revenue growth and profitability than if we just look straight down at the end of those links in the chain. We're going to produce a better outcome when we look at the beginning of the chain. And again, that is internal service quality. This is workplace design, job design, employee selection and development. So how well are we recruiting and interviewing and hiring and onboarding and building into our team members? How do we reward and recognize them? What tools do we provide them in order to serve customers more effectively? When we focus more on internal service quality, the research shows that we produce higher employee satisfaction. I know, again, it's intuitive, it makes sense, but when we produce employee satisfaction, these guys have proven that we produce employee retention and employee productivity. So obviously, employee retention is very, very valuable to the company. There is some positive attrition that occurs, you know, maybe a B player or a C player or someone who doesn't really share the values or the purpose or the mission that really brings everyone to life and brings us back to work every day. Some people leave because or are eliminated because they're not great fits for a variety of purposes. In general, though, these B plus and A players, we really want to retain them because it's a huge cost savings. Anyone who's hired someone recently knows how time consuming and therefore expensive it can be to do a good job of recruiting, interviewing, selecting, hiring, onboarding a new team member. So employee retention has obvious value in and of itself, but employee satisfaction also produces employee productivity. We get more out of everyone every single day when we increase engagement and satisfaction by focusing on, again, internal service quality. Now, the outcome of that is external service value. This is customer value. We're producing better results for customers. And we're not just talking about wow moments or surprise and delight that productive, retained, and satisfied employees can produce. Those are all nice to haves. The need to have and the real money is in desired outcomes, getting people to their actual specific goals. When we do that, the wow moments and surprise and delight are icing on the cake. The most important thing we can do is deliver results for our customers. And again, Heskett, Schlesinger, and Sasser have all proven that internal service quality produces better employees, retained employees, and more productive employees that produce value for customers. Now, value for customers produces, obviously, customer satisfaction. We're in this zone here of where the customer experience is created when we move front of the house employees into specific customer delivery and customer value. So this customer satisfaction of designing and delivering services that meet and exceed customers' needs and wants is where we create satisfaction. A satisfied customer is a loyal customer. This produces retention, repeat business, referral business, and all those other things that make producing the entire business model and delivering a customer experience even more valuable, because this is where the revenue stacks. We made the investment once, and because we did such a good job in building up our employees to deliver great experience, that customers are loyal and they come back for more and they bring other people. And the two proven consequences there are revenue growth and profitability. So those are the links in the service profit chain. So that's a quick look at the service profit chain. In conclusion, two interrelated points. Number one, employee experience drives our customers' experiences. The better the employee experience, the better the customer experience. And the better the customer experience, the better the financial results. And point two, when we're in those expensive meetings, what are our points of conversation? What are we focusing on? Can we not work across teams and across departments as leaders in our organizations to create and deliver higher internal service quality? Again, that is the recruiting, interviewing, hiring, onboarding, equipping, engaging, and developing of our people. How can we create a better employee experience? And can we not take a little bit more time in our day-to-day, week-to-week, month-to-month to do a better job of that? I encourage you to check out the Service Profit Chain. It is available as a book. It's available as an HBR.org or Harvard Business Review article. So if you just Google the Service Profit Chain, you can check out an image search to see the model that I walked through and check out the story at HBR.org. It's a really good one. And if you find yourself engaged there, maybe then step up into the book. Again, my name is Ethan Beute. Thank you so much for listening to the B2B Growth Show. If you want to hear more about the customer experience in general, I encourage you to check out the Customer Experience Podcast, available everywhere that you would listen to a podcast. And it's available at bombbomb.com/podcast. That's bombbomb.com/podcast. I do overviews with video clips and takeaways from every single episode there in the blog at bombbomb.com/podcast. Thanks so much and have a great rest of your day.
We totally get it. We publish a ton of content on this podcast, and it can be a lot to keep up with. That's why we've started the B2B Growth Big Three, a no-fluff email that boils down our three biggest takeaways from an entire week of episodes. Sign up today at sweetfishmedia.com/big3. That's sweetfishmedia.com/big3.